Now it's my privilege and pleasure to introduce the speaker on my right. He has joined us from Nepal, and he has a very distinguished pedigree. The Reverend Damodar Gautam is the chairman of the Interreligious Council of Nepal and is a renowned figure in Nepal's interfaith community. Reverend Gautam was active in the Democratic People's Movement of 1965, a well-known movement. He's an active member of the Nepali Congress, one of the nation's largest democratic parties. Reverend Gautam also serves currently as the president of Sanjeevani Service Association, which provides aid to various hospitals in Nepal, as well as the advisor of the Pashupati Area Development Trust and chief advisor of the World Hindu Federation Nepal National Committee. Please give a warm welcome to Reverend Gautam.
First of all, I am from Nepal. I am very appreciate to say to every interfaith communities, and I regard all the prophet and sacred books like in Nepali Jai, you know. Jai means nice of the community. Jai Moses, Jai Zarathustra, Jai Mahavira, Jai Mahabuddha, Jai Confucius, Jai Tao, Jai Jesus Christ, Jai Muhammad, Assalamu Alaikum also, Shinto, Jagat Guru Shankaracharya, Guru Nanak, many lords, and ladies and gentlemen, I have a little knowledge. I writing a book in this world. We have facially and interfaith groups also, like Muslim, like Christian, white, like Hindus, like Negro and Hafsi, and Buddhist like Mongolian and Aryan. We are fighting once another. I support firstly Dr. Farooq's statement. I am also the presenting this paper, Unity in Diversity. In this books, I written the many prophets and many good leaders also, as like Moshe, Zoroastrian, Agam and Mahavira, Buddha, Quran, Bible, Taoism, Shintoism, Confucianism, and others, as like best democratic leader Abraham Lincoln, Mahatma Gandhi, B.P. Koirala, and Nelson Mandela also. My topics is the, not only my topics, this unity in diversity building, social cohesion and sustainable peace through universal aspiration, principle and values in these topics. The main theme of the convention, unity in diversity, very good topics, you know. But it is not too easy, because there are varieties of problems in this universe. Most of the society of the universe have faced misled by their bad tradition and customs. There are many problems of society, societies as castes, outcastes, races, backward tribes, indigenous groups, lower caste, upper caste, untouchable group, Dalit, as like in India and Nepal, ethnic groups, religious community, interfaith groups, continental, regional, American, African, Oceania, Asian, European, Aryan, Mongolian, white, black, Negro, as well as holy personality, Lord Shiva, Rama, and Krishna, Messiah, Moses, Saint Confucius, Tao and Shinto, Lord Mahavira and Buddha, Messiah Jesus Christ, Prophet Muhammad, Muhammad and Saint Jagat Guru Shankaracharya and Kabir, etc. And sacred scriptures also, Vedas, Upanishad, Gitas, Avesta, Torah, Agam, Dhammapada, Bible, Quran, Guru Granth Sahib and etc. About the very holy personality and sacred scripture teach us no discrimination within the society in the manifestation of God. But we are not following that so. I have example in the Eastern philosophy. I am Nija Paraveti, Lavusha Gana Chetasam, Udara Charita Nam to Vasudeva Kutumbakam. That means Hitopades in Sanskrit. That means only the narrow-minded peoples say my or yours, and discrimination in the each other's, whereas broad-minded and liberal ones behave all people in the world as their relatives and family members. Vasudhaiva kutumbakam, as well as one family under the God. Unfortunately, people in the same countries where such human civilization were founded are these days involve the killing each others. It would not be exaggeration to say that these essence of above lines become meaningless due to conflict between Shia and Sunni, Protestant and Catholics, Digambara and Swetambara, Hinayana and Mahayana, Saiva and Vaishnava, and among the other religious groups. In my an inter-religious council, Nepal has been formed in Nepal, representing all the religious society in the country. Let us join in the council all the religious society in words of Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Buddhist, Shinto, Confucius, Tao, and other religions to unite the prevails in this prevail the peace and fraternity across the world. The unity in diversity among the determined and faithful people like Muslim, simple and cooperative people like Christian, liberal, enduring and inclusive people like Hindu, Buddhist, Jain and Sikhs, Kirat, peace and reconciled people, Shintoist and Japanese people, as Japanese people can be sources of peace, reconciliation, happiness, prosperity and salvation in the world. And that is the way for the welfare of the world, whole world. And other next example also, I am Sarva Dharma Priya, loving all the religious, loving all the religions, would like to call upon people from religious to unite, to note to the distress each others, believe and the respect all holy lands, including Mecca, Medina, Jerusalem, Bethlehem, Ayodhya, Lumbini, Pashupati, Nepal, Gurudwara, Mathura, Jinjaj and Kamis in Japan, study in all religious scripts, including the Quran, Bible, Shintoism, Dhammapada and Agam, Vedas and Upanishad, and other scripts. In Rig Veda, I give the example in the Eastern philosophy, in the mean philosophy, in the Sangachaddham, Sambadaddham, Sambho Manavsi Janatam, Deva Bhagi Utha Purvi Sajaranam Upasati. It means, oh man, let us together, as well as dialogue together between one another, share your feelings together, practice new things, then worship yourself as your tradition and unite yourself. Lastly, I am feeling now that all the pure prophet and great personality have come down to this earth, because here is too much atrocity in this world. Lord Buddha come again for non-violence and peace. Prophet Muhammad come for organize and command different groups of the society. Mahavir for non-violence and sacrifice. Guru Nanak for peace and politeness. Jesus Christ come truth and love. Ram and Kamsa to be finish atrocious Ravana and Kamsa. Sintoist come peace, reconciliation and coexistence. Bahaullah for world unite, peace and harmony. Lord Shiva for Satyam Shivam Sundaram. Means truth, welfare and beauty. Then we get the unity in diversity in this universe. Lastly, I am obliged to the organization, Global Peace Foundation, who give me this opportunity and invite me. I wish this organization would get grand success in the every path of this mission. I pray all the best. Assalamu alaikum. Jai Allah, Jai Masih, Jai Sintu, Jai Tao, Jai Confucius, Jai Ishwar, Jai Shambhu, Jai Mahavir, Jai Buddha, Jai Guru Nanak, Jai Guru, Jai Kami, Jai Malaysia, Jai Nepal, Jai Vishwa, world. Thank you for all participants. Thanks.